It's been 4 days since his high-profile arrest in Florida, but today Roger Stone was arraigned in district court.
Yeah, his appearance comes just one day after the Justice Department indicated special counsel's Russia probe may come to a close soon. Fox News correspondent Lauren Blanchard is in Washington with more.
After a weekend of publicity and TV appearances, this morning Roger Stone was back in court, entering his plea on charges of witness tampering, obstruction, and lying to Congress. The president's former advisor, Roger Stone, departed district court uncharacteristically silent, passing by throes of supporters and protesters after pleading not guilty to 7 counts in the Russia investigation. In an interview last night on Fox, Stone alleged special counsel Robert Mueller had him arrested to silence him.
Because I support Donald Trump and I've been a critic of the Mueller investigation.
But Democrats like Senator Ron Wyden say the Stone indictment shows a disturbing pattern within the Trump campaign.
What it is all about is not just their lying, but what they are lying about. And what they are lying about is colluding with the Russians.
The more that this goes on, the more and more we see that none of these things have anything to do with the president.
Meanwhile, acting Attorney General Matthew Whitaker drawing criticism on Capitol Hill for saying the Mueller investigation could soon be wrapping up.
The investigation is, close to being completed.
No responsible prosecutor will predict with any kind of timeline when an investigation will conclude.
Although a gag order was not issued on Roger Stone today, it could still happen Friday when he returns for a hearing with the same judge handling Paul Manafort's case. For now, Stone's travel is restricted to Florida, Washington, D.C., and New York. In Washington, Lauren Blanchard, Fox News.